Okay, back online. So you went to St. Paul the Apostle in Loyola, and I know you learned a lot of poetry. The poems you learned, sort of Catholic poems, are those mostly from Loyola or mostly from St. Paul or a mixture?
I think mostly from Loyola, but we had to there's a lot of memorization in Catholic education, from catechism on, and you know, who made us, God made us, and so on and so forth. And you get used to it. There's something, you take something away from it. I always tried to memorize something, whether it was poetry or something, from every class I took, so I could appear smarter, as if I knew a lot from that class.
But you still remember them.
Poetry, let me say something before I forget, were the songs that we used to sing, and especially from Nuria, when I had to wait for Nuria at her school. She was doing Pirates of Penzance, and she had a part in the chorus, and I would sit there and listen to that, and I was mesmerized by that, and I really learned almost the whole operetta by heart, and I could sing the, "Oh Ruth, you have deceived me," both parts, both the woman's part and the man's part, the woman's part an octave higher.
You never played in an orchestra, did you?
Oh yes, I played, but not very well. I played cello in the St. Paul's School Orchestra. Larry was in that too. And as a matter of fact, there were a couple girls that I really liked that were older than I was when I must have been in around the fifth grade, and they were in the seventh or eighth grade. Lois, well, they played the piano, Lois Fanta, and then Mary Ray Fanta. And then there was another girl, Pat Clark, who played piano too, and she was older than I was. I don't know why I was like the older girls, and I was very good friends with her. And then I did something, I can't remember what, but I got really mad at her. I think I knew that this love couldn't last, you know, because she was older than I was and good looking. And I said, I somehow insulted her, and then I never talked to her again.
That was an orchestra.
An offshoot of my playing cello and orchestra. That's what made the orchestra interesting for me.
But when you got to Loyola, you didn't do that?
No, I wasn't any good in cello, and I never, well, they didn't have.
Did you have lessons in cello, just at school?
We had lessons, all of us had lessons, first in piano and then in violin. And as a matter of fact, I played a duet with Nuria at UES, University Elementary School, in which she had a big part, and I had a part. I think my whole thing was the A string, and then one time I had to go to the D string, and I think I messed up, if I recall. But I was probably only in the first, I couldn't have been more than the second grade. So
did your parents go to that, like parents go to recitals?
They must have been, I don't remember that.
That must have been tough.
Poor family.
That must have been interesting for them. Nuria, did she go to UES?
And Nuria went to UES. Nuria was not.
But not St. Paul.
Not St. Paul's. Yeah. And on to, she went to UES, then Emerson Junior High School, and then Uni High, and then UCLA.
Then she went to Ojai Valley, didn't she, for
she
one?
She went for a year. She went, somebody convinced my parents that this was a wonderful school where she should go, and she went there for a year.
That was a boarding school, right?
Yeah.
Was that tough, a strange thing to have your sister go off to boarding school? Or do you remember that? Was it good?
Well, like most kids, I'm involved with myself. I didn't think that much of it. I remember we went out and visited her every once in a while. In a way, I think it was strange to be separated from her because we were very close. Mary and I were always very close. We used to play. When I started playing tennis, we played tennis together all the time and went back and forth from the courts. And later, when I played in tournaments, she would drive me there. And we had a very close relationship as kids.
So Loyola, I assume you talked about the tennis things already with Ricky at Loyola and at Notre Dame. But how did you get from Loyola to Notre Dame?
Yeah, I don't think I talked about that. I was a senior in Loyola, and you know, I really, when I think about it, I reached my peak at 15, And after that, I sort of lived on my record. I had just enough good wins to make it look as if I was good, but really, I was getting passed very quickly by my compatriots because they were getting bigger and I wasn't, and they were getting stronger and I wasn't. And I never was really, you know, a tennis player is either strong and big, or he's short and fast. And I was weak and slow. And so I think I made my way up in tennis by boring people to death and just hitting the ball back to their weak backhands until they missed the shot. But at any rate, I still had a pretty good record by the time I was 18, and I got ranked nationally 17th in doubles and 21 in singles, so it wasn't too bad. But before that happened, I'd had a few wins that year. I beat the national interscholastic champion. He was the reigning champion, but he was now going to USC, and we played UCLA freshmen, and I had some other wins over ranked players and got to the semis and national hard courts and things. So I had some claim to fame, you know, people thought I might still be good, but I really was very surprised when my coach asked me if I was interested in going to Notre Dame because he could get me a scholarship there. So I said I was, and they offered me a full scholarship, room, board, tuition, meals, laundry, everything, but books, just about everything you could ask for in a scholarship. And for somebody like me in a sport like tennis, I thought that was a pretty good deal. I wanted to get away from home. I did not have a good relationship with my mother. And this was a way of my getting away and being independent, or I thought independent. And so I jumped at the chance and took it. Whether it was a mistake or not, I don't know. But
did you have other options?
I had to accept. They said I had to accept right away, which I did. It was very early, and I had somebody at Stanford said that they thought they could get me something, but they weren't sure. And Redlands, but it was still very early. Mm-hmm. But I never would have got something like this, I don't think, from any other legitimate school.
So was your mom happy to send you off to Notre Dame?
I don't know. As I say,